is able to read that tape, and we assure 30 years of reading the tapes. Bakla.org, okay, here you can go and search and download our software. Features. It's open source. It's centrally managed. It's a network backup and restore. It has many platforms. I can assure you that we almost have 99% of all platforms. We run our software on it. We are able to do backups from almost all platforms available. Currently, and soon we're going to release backups to Android and to iPhone, okay? It stores in different media, tape, disk, USB, DVD, CD, NAS, storage, KINAP, whatever. It's reliable, and in here, we guarantee almost 100% of our restores, okay? And I can guarantee you that, okay? And it's made by C, so it's almost fault tolerant. Knows what was backupped and when and where, because we have use our Postgres catalog to store every piece of file, every backup job is stored in a Postgres database. So we know when, where, and where is the files. We allow restoring files you want by a catalog, by console, or by a graphical user interface. You have restores to point in time and scales to handle 10,000 machines, and it's open to customization. About the scales, Bakla community version, it scales very fast and without any issue. It works very well with the small machines, 5 clients, 1 server. It also works very well with 40,000 machines with 1 server and 2 storage daemons. I will explain after what's a storage daemon, you'll understand. And it scales very fast. And we don't care about the size of data that you do. We just want you to do backups and keep them safe. And it's open to customization. It's one of the beauties of Bakla community and enterprise vision is you are able to create your own scripts to do specify backups of special software that you have inside your company or inside your house. We do a multi-volume backup, okay? We do multiplex backups. You can do, it depends on our hardware, but you can do 50 jobs at the same time, 150 backup jobs at the same time, okay? We do differential, incremental, and virtual full backups. Virtual full backups, it's a full backup, but it doesn't touch the clients. What it does is it does a backup using the same data that it already has, but after it finishes that full backup with the data that he already has, he does a search to the client and asks, so, do you have differentials? And the client says, yes, I have. So he gets that differentials inputs in the virtual full backup. This way you can create fulls in a very fast way, and in terms of safety and organized, it's fantastic. Then we have copy and migration jobs. What is copy and migration jobs? You have storage daemons. With Bakla Community Edition, this is all a network backup software, so it's decoupled. You can have, for example, your central manager in Portugal, and you can have a storage daemon in California, where you save your backups, and you can have another storage daemon in Japan, and then you can do a copy job from California to Japan, like disaster recovery. So have the data in 2 places, or you can do a migration job, for example, migrate all my backups from California that I'm going to close the office to Japan. Okay, you can do that on the fly with a Buckley Community Edition and the Enterprise Edition. We control bandwidth. You are able to control bandwidth and set, okay, this client is going to only do 10 megabits per second, or this job only does X per second. We don't have memory leaks, okay? And we have automatic volume recycle. This means that you have a rotation period, and after the rotation period, Buckla will reuse all your tapes or your volumes. Another features, we have grandfather, father, son backups and other backup strategies compliant. We do file system snapshot and support LVM, ZFS, and almost all the file systems that you have. We have network traffic compression. As already said, 30 years of backward backup compatibility. Our storage format, it's open, okay? Like Unix and dump. Our catalog in Postgres is open. We have deduplication and we have network deduplication. And what is deduplication? Deduplication is a technology is available on only on enterprise version, okay? Deduplication basically is you do a full backup of a client. Next, you're going to do an incremental the next day. On the next day, you're going to do another incremental. After a week, you do again another full. So right now, on your storage side, you have two fulls of the client with almost all the same information. But you have 10 terabytes of information. From one is 5 terabytes, and the other full has 5 terabytes. With the duplication, what happens is you do a full. The second full that is going to do is going to check which data blocks the storage daemon already has. And from the client is going to only get the new data blocks or the new changed data blocks. This means instead of having 10 terabytes of two fulls in your storage daemon, probably you're going to have 6 terabytes. Now imagine this multiplied by all your backups infrastructure. So you have 10, imagine, 10 computers with Linux from CentOS or Ubuntu. They have all the same data blocks. So you don't need to save always the same data. And we do deduplication on the file system and on the network at the same time. This means that when I start to get the data from the client, I ask, hey, do you have, which files do you already have? I already have these files. Okay, so just give me this, and this piece of information. So in terms of network, I will not get all the data, just a little piece of the data that was changed. So this saves time and bandwidth in your network. This doesn't seem very much, but I will try to explain. We have all platforms covered, as I said. We do almost all databases backup. We do all backups to all databases. Postgres, MySQL, NoSQL, DB2, SAP HANA. We have cloud. You are able to provide backups to cloud. You can do, for example, backups to a storage daemon locally, and then, if you want, you can use Amazon as an archive and do, without touching the clients, from our storage daemon, uploading to the cloud. We have replication, we have data management, we have a REST API, so you can develop your own software and scripts and use REST. We have a backup service software. We use a B-Web, it's our graphical user interface. We do virtualization backups, VMware, Hyper-V, KVM, I can hear Swift, Proxmox, and Red Hat, Red Hat HV. Currently now, since version 12 and since version the last version of Buckle Community version, all the traffic between machines and the directory are encrypted out of the box. Okay? All the traffic is encrypted. Architecture. How this works, how it is configured. So I will try to. Okay. So here is our director. Basically, BEE or Bakula is divided in three components, three major components. The first and the most important one is the director. Okay. This could be one machine for 20,000 servers. Okay. We have customers with more than 20,000 clients doing backups with one machine, one server. The director basically is the machine that controls and schedules the backups, where the operator connects. The operator connects via text console or a graphic console or a graphical web interface to the director and issues all the commands, backup jobs, restores, sets priorities, stops backup, cancel. The director stores all the information in a SQL catalog. Currently, we support three databases, SQLite, MySQL, and Postgres. I advise you always to use Postgres in terms of scalability. It scales very fast. I will give you a number. The biggest customer has 1 petabyte of a Postgres database. Okay? So you can see the size of it. The actual size of the database. And it works and it's fast. And we provide support also. So then we have the director. Then we have the storage daemon. The storage daemon basically is the daemon that controls where you are going to save your data, your information. Okay? So basically, it does that. The global end duplication is that the duplication engine that I told before, it's attached to the storage daemon. So the storage daemon storage in virtual tape libraries, in disk array, in tapes, and on the cloud. The storage daemon is responsible for saving the data in these four major components. Okay, we have all the clouds, so you can have an hybrid solution. Okay? Okay, you have local backups, and suddenly, right now I need to have an archive, or let's try Amazon. So you can use Amazon. And you don't need to pay anything more. Okay. Then you have the clients and have models. This schema is about the Buckle Enterprise Edition, okay? In the Community Edition, you have almost the same features instead of these plugins, okay? This plugin is on the Enterprise Edition, but Buckle Community Edition is open, so you can develop your own Oracle plugin or your own exchange without major issue. And we don't bother with that. Use it. And share with us. And we have all the clients that you can imagine. Windows, CentOS, Debian, Red Hat, SUSE, Solaris, Ubuntu, Mac, HP, UX. Okay? All these clients, we do have an agent to do backups. I miss you one thing. In every server that you want to backup, you must install an agent, a Buckle Community or Enterprise Edition agent. That agent is responsible for sending the data to the director and to the storage daemon. Okay? And you have nice features. You can, for example, before you start doing a MySQL database backup, you can stop. You can issue a press script before starts the backup. It does something to the database or freezes. You do the backup, and then you can issue later a second command to start again the database. Who says the database could be a VM? It could be a, don't know, send an email or copy pictures or move from a folder to another. So you are able to do that. So as I said, Backup Director is a service that supervises all the backup, restores, verify, and archive operation. The system administrator uses Backup Director to schedule jobs and to recover files. The director runs as a daemon or a service in the background. Backup Storage consists of the software program that performs storage and recovery of the file attributes and data to physical backup, media, or volumes. Is responsible for reading, writing your tapes or other storage media, example files. The storage device runs as a daemon that has the backup device, usually a tape drive. I cannot say numbers. There is a customer, a Portuguese customer, CGD is our customer. And their tape library is huge. Okay? It's more than 100 tape drives. And it does the backups all the same time. Okay?
I have robots with 2 petabytes each of LTU tapes.
LTU2? Okay. And you can use that with Backup. That's the beauty, because if you have old hardware, no problem. You can use it. Backup client, that's the client that I explained you before, is the software that installs in the machine to be backed up. It specifies the operating system on which runs and is responsible for providing file attributes and data when requested by the director. File server responsible for file system dependent part of restoring file attributes and data to the recovery operation. This program runs as a daemon as the other before. Then you have the catalog. The catalog is what I said before, is the place where you save your files. You save the metadata of your files, the directories. Each file, each that backups is a record in the database. And the catalog serves part simple backups like that because maintains a record of all volumes, all jobs, and all files saved, permitting efficient restoration and volume management. Currently, we support MySQL, Postgres, and SQLite. Backup console. Console basically is a console like a Linux shell, but we have a B console shell for Backup that you can issue the commands and issue backups and restores. So what's the beauty of this, having this kind of decoupled architecture? So you can have a database in Brazil, the director in Portugal, a storage daemon in the United States, a storage daemon in China, I hope not, but... And the storage, this one saves to tape library, and this one saves to cloud. And you can do a disk-to-disk copy. So you can have something like this. One of the customers has 10 data centers, one director, 10 storage daemons, all doing 24-hour backups. It never stops. One director. So this is the main advantage of Backup Community Edition and Enterprise version. Graphical users interface. There is mostly 3 of them. Backloom. Backloom is from a Polish colleague of mine. Marcin is the most active one currently and the most beautiful one. Unfortunately, I'm unable to show you because of my VM, but I was prepared to show you this one. Reportla. This one was developed by me 4 years ago. And you have B-Web. It's from David, an Italian that is living in Switzerland. He's also working at Backup Systems and is a colleague of mine. So he's also one of the nicest graphical user interface that you can use. These two, most of them they are doing is reporting, okay? Backloom currently does configuration out of the box with a click base. You don't need to edit text files, okay? And for Windows or for Kite, you have BAT. It's another graphical user interface. Enterprise Edition. For companies and for us, Bacalo Community Edition and Enterprise Edition work together. Okay? We have a philosophy that every piece of time we release some code of the Enterprise Edition to the Community Edition. Okay? Bacalo Systems was built to provide support and to keep Bacalo Community Edition alive. And this is the headquarters in Switzerland. We are a backup and recover software specialist. Our headquarters is in Switzerland. And why? Because of this. Okay? Neutrality and inviolability. You have own office industry in America, Asia, Europe, Latin America, and Oceania. And more than 2 million installed backups clients all around the world. This is Enterprise Edition. Community Edition, we don't probably, we have an idea, but we don't know. I can assure you that we worked for, I worked in my previous job before I entered in Bacalo Systems for 10 years with the Community Edition, doing backups to 1,000 machines, and it works, and we didn't have the need to go to the Enterprise Edition. But if you want, we can, you can have it, and we provide support. World customers. NASA, Biofarm, Sky, Lincoln Laboratory, Datapipe, Turner Studios, it's the television from Hollywood, Baylor University, Carnegie Mellon University, Armazém Paraíba, it's the Sonai in Brazil, Câmara Municipal de Campinas, Datacom, SOSIC, Carrefour, Atacadão, it's the Intermarché of Brazil, Governo Federal do Brasil, Ministério da Defesa da Marinha do Brasil, Navy, Caixa Geral de Depósitos em Portugal, Groupon, Swisscom, Astrium, Bank of Austria, Airbus, Volkswagen, T-Mobile, Santander, University of Basel, and NATO. NATO is one of the special customers. Everything is encrypted. That was one major request from them. And that's why they choose Bacalo Enterprise Edition. This is our customer reviews, okay? This is from our customers. We don't do anything about this. Our customers gives us reviews. So from 10, you have a point of 9.7. You can go here, Trust Radius, and search for Bacalo Enterprise. And now, Bacalo Workshop. I will stop just a bit because I'm going to show next a little bit of how Bacalo works. Unfortunately, I wanted to show you how to install, but I'm unable to do it. But we'll show it already installed. So, but before I start, do you have any questions about this? Yeah. It depends, in that side. Okay. Depends on the virtualization or the hypervisor technology you use it. If it's VMware, you can do a CBT, like a change block technology, because VMware gives that. So we use API from VMware, and you can do a restore just for that few data blocks. You don't need to do the whole VM, the restore of the whole VM. And it applies also to the backup of the VM, okay? You don't need to pull all the VM. If you have already a full from your side, we're just going to grab that changes, the two changes, data blocks that the VM has. But that's VMware. Xen, or Xen. Xen only released that in the Citrix version, the paid version, as I probably 1 year ago. Okay, so we are using now with Xen, but before we didn't use it. Okay, in that part we use what the hypervisor gives you, give us. We don't reinvent much the wheel. If the hypervisor technology provides us tools, we use that tools. A subscription model. Yes. No. No. It's, we have, I'm not the the salesperson, but we have a subscription model, okay? We don't care the number of bytes or terabytes you do backups, okay? It's not like a bag of potatoes behind codes, like, okay, you do 10 gigabytes, you pay 10 gigabytes. No, we don't care how much gigabytes you do backup. We have a subscription model in terms of support is based on the number of machines and the size of your infrastructure. Okay, but it's advisable. For example, we have a customer that does backups about 50 clients, but it has petabytes of information. He only has 50. Okay, and we have, for example, 1,000 clients on another customer, and he only does terabytes. So we don't care about the data. Of course, you if you have two directors, there is a change in the price of the subscription. Okay, so in terms of subscription, it's about the size of the number of machines. If you ask me the number, I cannot tell you because I don't know. But you can go to the site and check. I didn't understand. Okay. See. 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 When DMP. A VTL. Estás a falar da parte do storage. Faz a duplication. Sim. Podes desligar. Podes desligar do backlog. Sim. He asked some storage hardware has already has deduplication behind. Okay, so how Bakla works with that? I told him that we have you can it's an option, a directive. You just say deduplication no, and you can specify deduplication no to this customer, to this client. Okay, you can have 20 doing the duplication and that one not doing. You are able to do that. But normally, that hardware vendors, they don't reinvent the wheel. What they have behind, normally, in the bottom is ZFS. So we have we call it a line plugin that you installed, and the line plugin communicates with the deduplication of ZFS and does that deduplication. Okay? Any more questions? No? Questions? No? Questões? Não? Sorry? It's the storage, yes. You can have volumes encrypted. The encryption starts. The encryption in the network was optional, okay? From version 10. From version 12, every communication is already encrypted out of the box, okay? But before it was optional, you had to configure. You have encryption over the communication and over the storage, okay? So your data is encrypted when it's saved, yeah. The encryption starts first on the client side. Before the data is sent from the client, is encrypted in the client, and then goes over the internet, encrypted back to us. And then we encrypt it again in the volume. Yeah. Yeah. It's an end-to-end encryption, yes. If you ask me, oh, it's safe. We use TLS and AES256, something like. Yeah. Any more questions? No? Okay, so I'm going to do a small break. Take a small break.
Estava a morrer, e aquilo era, na altura, a base de dados era feita por uns gajos que eram da Frontports, que entretanto foram comprados pela Oracle.
Sim.
E eu não faço ideia em que formato é que aquela porcaria está, se aquilo é mais ou menos fácil de interpretar por outra.
Se é Oracle, que deve fazer dump ou uma coisa qualquer. Pá, o que eu te aconselho para aproveitares hardware antigo é fazeres backups momentâneos. Se for em disco, se for em tape, pá, fazer arquivo, coisas, pá, isso é sempre válido, percebes?
Nós o que fazemos é, temos uma base de dados que sabe um determinado clipe, tanto bloco tal ou bloco tal, e esse clipe tem não sei quantos metadados associados, que é para nós sabermos, imagina, queres ir procurar uma peça em que o Cavaco Silva disse uma porcaria que mudou o usuário qualquer em 92,
sim,
e isto cola os metadados que nós temos no vídeo, com o início do bloco e o fim do bloco está na tape, não sei o quê, ou seja, o robô tem que saber que ir buscar a tape à magazine, não sei o quê, vai buscar e tal, faz restore, mete no disco e depois está no disco, o gajo manda pela rede até ao sítio nós fazemos o workflow um bocadinho diferente.
Sim, já percebi, já percebi. É um workflow um bocadinho diferente. O que eu te posso dizer é que tu tens uma base de dados em Postgres, tu podes aceder à base de dados e fazeres essa pesquisa. Estás a entender? Ou seja, o Bacula faz os backups, mas o nome dos ficheiros está lá guardado na base de dados. Tu podes fazer a pesquisa e ele depois vai-te dizer, está nesta tape, e podes fazer um script em que ele faz-te logo o issue do restore, logo direto.
Tens lá Bacula? Eu tenho, não sei quantos petas em tapes até a 2, mas desde 92 guardamos todo o vídeo que temos, temos produzido peças e tudo mais.
Sim, sim, desde
que assim que existe, não trabalhamos com isso.
Fecha?
Mas há uma coisa, um arquivo que nunca mais acaba. E foi guardado em quê? É guardado em tapes, ele guardado em quê? Ah, isto na altura foi o Sonic Windows System. O sistema da Sony chama-se Sonic Petabyte. Pá, e entretanto já foram, já venderam aquilo, ou outros gajos compraram. Pronto, aquilo já vou mandar tudo de volta. Até a própria Sony, nós agora encerramos o site. Durante este ano, nós quando vemos os robôs de um lado para o outro, pá, quase que precisa ir a Fátima.
Pois, assim, claro.
E conseguem ler aquilo que está lá? Conseguem ler? Só sei reparar?
Felizmente ficou tudo bom. Conseguimos transportar os dois robôs e ligá-los, assim, e está tudo ok.
E está fora das acessíveis? Agora migra para 7.
Pois, só que o problema é migrar os dados e os metadados todos estão associados.
O problema é os metadados.
Aqueles conectores para os outros softwares que nós temos para pesquisar isto. Isto é uma cadeia de software que nunca mais acaba.
Por isso é que eu estou a dizer, epá, tu com o Bacula consegues. A parte dos metadados, tens uma base de dados Postgres e depois tem que alguém fazer um desenvolvimento. Tem que fazer o desenvolvimento e ir lá àquela base de dados. Porque isso é petas e petas. Epá, até é fácil, sabes? Tu, a nível de uma pesquisa, tu tens muito gráfico linters interface só ligado à ABD, não é? Aquilo é aberto. O campo é um campo com o path todo e depois com o file name à frente. E claro, associado ao job ID, ao volume name e a data em que foi e os números de bytes, não é assim? Aquilo está ali escarrapachado, não percebes? Não é nada assim de. Essa é a grande vantagem da community do Bacula Enterprise. Nós não limitamos as pessoas. Percebes? Nós, estás a ver, eu dei-te uma solução. Se é melhor. Percebes? Mas tens uma solução. Há um caminho possível. É. Sim.
Vai mudando os sistemas e vai. Quando o pessoal, se calhar, assim, compareceu mesmo, pediu ter comprado. Se calhar, a empresa tivesse falido, não tivesse fechado. Podem comprar os sistemas seguintes, os upgrades. O Estado tem problema que é lançar um curso, depois ganhar esta empresa. Ganhar aquela, ou seja, começamos com o Symantec, Exec, backups,
Sim, não se vai embora. Não se vai embora.
E por aí tem tapes, não quer dizer 3,
um gigante entre vários.
2 e 3 com produtos diferentes para migrar para a coisa. Portanto, isso é um bocado manual. Passa tudo para storage e depois voltar a fazer backup para a noção.
Sim, sim. Vamos dizer um bocado.
E como acontece mesmo, é um sistema em que haja as tais os 30 anos de continuidade. Nós pudéssemos comparar.
Nós garantimos isso.
Sim, mas a questão é nos concursos. Eu não consigo garantir
sim,
que a empresa
claro.
É sempre a mesma.
Aí é que está. A vantagem é essa. Por exemplo, nós para já somos uma empresa internacional. Na Caixa Geral de Depósitos, quem montou foi uma empresa espanhola. Mas temos o representante português. Cá. Mas ganhou a empresa espanhola.
Mas é trabalhar com o mesmo sistema.
Com o mesmo software. Percebes? O software é o mesmo. Nós conseguimos te garantir isso, independente agora. Então. Sim, eu sei. Mas podes fazer uma lifetime subscription que existe. É a comprar por X anos. Compras um pacote de 5 anos. Eu não sei os valores, mas existe. Lifetime subscription. Temos muita subscrição. Nato, acho que a Nato é uma dessas. Podes comprar subscrição de 5 anos. Tens acesso a tudo. Estás a ver? Ou suporte a tudo. Durante 5 anos. Sim, mas isso vais ter de sempre ter um acompanhamento de um consultor cá. Isso, mesmo a formação.
Já tinha visto na parte do comunitário, já tinha explorado um bocadinho isso, mas nunca tinha explorado.
Isto é para conheceres. É uma hipótese. Vamos continuar. Não sei se eu. Bom, sim, mais um bocadinho, isto é mais rápido agora. Infelizmente eu não tenho, vou falar em português. Português, inglês? Português ou inglês? Português? Ok, pronto. Toda a gente é português. Pronto, é mais fácil. Pronto, infelizmente eu não vou conseguir fazer a instalação toda do Bácula, da Community Version, mas vocês vão perceber que é muito fácil, ok? Há uns 5 anos atrás não era assim, tínhamos que compilar pacotes, mas agora as coisas. Lá está. Sim. 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 Sim, é. A curva de aprendizagem é elevada. É. 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 A filosofia, aquilo. É. Para teres noção, eu durante um ano. A primeira vez só conseguia pôr uma drive a gravar. Tinha uma tape library com 8 e só lá estava uma a gravar. Depois é que descobri como é que punha as outras 8. Tive um ano assim. E cada vez que aquilo fazia reboot, perdia os devices da drive. Depois lá descobri, pá, pronto. Mas estamos a falar há 10 anos atrás, que não havia os fóruns. Sim, sim. Bom. Ok, os tópicos que nós vamos falar... I'm going to speak in English. The topics that we are going to speak about in this workshop is about Bácula installation, client configuration, storage, director components, director configuration, backups, restore, and finally some questions. How Bácula Community Edition is installed? First, you need a Postgres database or a MySQL. So this is trivial. Do a sudo apt-get install transport HTTPS, install Postgres in Postgres client, and then check if the Postgres is on. And I have a typo here. Let me... Okay. I have a typo here, but to install Bácula Community Edition, you just need to do sudo apt-get install Bácula director. Okay? I will show you. Okay? Because here I just put it Bakla the status to check the service. As I said before, Bakla has three daemons. So the storage daemon, the director, and the file daemon. Okay? All of these are running on the same machine, but you can decouple it. Okay? After you install, you run sudo bconsole. This bconsole, it's the console that connects to Bakla, and you are able to manage everything. Run backup job, restore. So you do a bconsole, and it appears like this. Okay? Now, client configuration. All configurations are done on a TXT file. We have customers doing some scripts that does this configuration. We have graphical user interface that edits this configuration. But basically, this is the client configuration. So I do a director and the password. This is the name of my client. It could be UbuntuCon, it could be Windows 10, it could be Postgres database, whatever. A working directory, the maximum concurrent jobs that this client permits, so I can limit this. The directory of plugins, and where it's the daemon is going to put it is listening port, the address. Storage definition, the same thing. I give a name, plugin, working directory, and then I give the director name or the director's name that is going to connect to a Bakla storage daemon. I can have one storage daemon and two directors connecting to that storage daemon. Okay? So you can have a director like a disaster recover. One is stopped and you are doing an rsync to another in Porto, for example. And when Lisbon disconnects, you can rise up the Porto and everything works because you have all configured in the storage. The storage configuration. This is auto-changer. Auto-changer is like the tape library, okay? And I define the name for the auto-changer, and I define the devices. The devices, basically, is the drive of the auto-changer, of the type library. In this case, I created a virtual auto-changer for two devices, and it will going to save data on a file. So I define device file changer dev one. I say that media type, it's a file one, okay? If it was a tape, I can put LTO5, LTO7. DVD, I can put DVD, USB, okay? I set the archive, where it's going to store the files. It could be a mount point, NFS. It could be a Samba. It could be a KNAPP or a share folder, or on the local. This is say to label the media. Random access is because it's a hard drive. Okay, it randoms. If it was a tape, I had to put sequential, yes. Automatic mount, that says not a tape, always open. And on this device, I only say that it's only to write 5 jobs on this device. So now, how this is works in terms of Bakla configuration. Bakla is a job philosophy in terms of backup. Job is an action or a task. And every job can be a restore job or a backup job. To do backups, every job must define type, what to do, if it's a backup, migrate, admin, or restore. We have admin jobs. And what is admin jobs? We can say, on your backup window, you do your backups, and then you create an admin job when all backups finish to send an email to your IT director or to do some tasks on your catalog database, like VacuumDB, cleaning all the database or re-indexing everything in the database after your backups jobs is finished. That's why we have admin jobs. We have the level, must say level, full differential incremental, a file set, The file set defines which kind of files or which kind of folders that you want to backup, include or exclude in your backup. A client, a storage, where you're going to put the storage, a pool, and a schedule. The schedule is where, when. You can say every day. You can say on every fourth of Friday in every month. You can say that. You can say, I want from the fifth day to the tenth day, like an interval. You can say that only on Saturday. So you can do that. And what is the pool? The philosophy of organization of Bakla, imagine this, a pool is your, I don't know, makes the stunt English. No, library. Okay. Imagine you have a library. It's a pool. A volume is one of the books that you put on the library. Okay? The files is every page of that book. Okay? This is the philosophy of Bakla. So you can create pools like, I want only to have a pool for incremental jobs. I want to only have a pool for full jobs. I want to create a pool just for database jobs. You can create things like that. And you can do migrate and copy jobs. So this is the definition of a job. One thing that we use is you can create job defs. Job defs, it's like when you are developing into object-oriented development, where you instantiate a job and inherits all the methods from another job. The same philosophy applies. So you create a job def, like a default job, says a backup, full set, schedule, storage, messages, pool, priority. And then you can create job backup client tool and say job depth default job. So this is the configuration of the job that inherits everything from above. But you can change this and set, for example, put a priority 9. Or you'd send like, okay, I won't use level incremental and set it like full. So you are able to use things like this. Client definition. This is how you configure your clients inside the Bakla director, okay? So you have configure the name, the address, the port, the catalog, a password, file retention, and job retention. And if it's prune, expired job files, if you want to archive or not. File set, and this is where the beauty happens with Bakla. So, this is a small example. This is, I said name, file setting, catalog. I include all files, the MD5 signature, and I include this file, Bakla SQL. But the file set is so powerful that you can do things like this. I just want to backup raw partitions. You can do like this. I want to backup the dev HDI, the hard disk HDI 2, or please execute a DF and show me what file systems are mounted, and I want to exclude TMPFS, SIFS, ISO, UDF and NFS, and it only shows these devices that are not here. So and backups all of this. I can do this. Okay? So you are able to, on the time of fly, imagine this, you only have a directory that is mounted only for a certain period of time. With a script inside or with a command, you are able on the fly, on the time of the backup job, to set, I just want that specific directory. That's all on the other time, it doesn't happen there. You can do this. Okay? That's the beauty of Bakla Community Edition and Enterprise Edition. It's open and it's very customizable. Another file set. I can do a compression. I can say, okay, compress all files. I can do this. Give me a file with a list of files inside, and Backlow is going to backup this. Backups this, and I can do exclude. For example, include all these directories, but exclude all files with a star O and all executed files. So it backups everything inside, but it excludes .exe files and O files. I can do things like this on the same file set. So I have two file sets. Okay? Pool. As I said, pool. Pool is a library. So you can create a pool default, a pool backup, and say recycle, and you can set the volume retention, the time that data is stored, and set the volume buts and the maximum volumes on the pool. Schedule. That's another thing that it's beautiful in Backlow community. You are able to do something like this. This job runs at the first Sunday of every month at 30:05. 23:05. You can do this. And run differential on the second and fifth Sunday. And run an incremental at Monday and Saturday. You have this. You can schedule like last. I want the full on last Friday, on the last day of February, May, and September. I can do this. It's possible. And you can set something like this. A level full, specify the pool. I want the job for pool monthly on the first Sunday. I want this job to go to the differential pool, and I want on the incremental to go to a daily pool. So it's very customizable. The auto changer. The auto changer, I already explained it. This is on the director side, okay? So you can have lots of auto changes here. From the director, you can put it, I said the file one, but I can put it auto changer or storage daemon France, storage daemon China, storage daemon California. So it's like this. So you set the address, the port, and the password. And you say like the device and the media type. So, and B console commands. Now I'm going to show you the commands, okay? And I'll show you how it runs. You have these commands that shows you everything about Backlow community version. Let me show you. Okay. So this is the VM. Okay. So this is the configuration files. I will open here to try understand. Okay, this is the configuration. So if I want to add a new job or a new client, I just need to here. Do like this. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, do a copy paste. I will not save this. Okay, but this is the configuration that I explained before. Okay. The job. The file set. Okay, this is the configuration. But how I administer? In this case, no. You need to install the plugin. Okay. How do you ask?
Um,
aqui. Ok? Está comentado. Esta é uma tape. Este é um LTO4. É uma tape. Ok? Eu só tenho que dizer o nome, o address, a porta e a password e o tipo de device. E o número de jobs que pode gravar ao mesmo tempo. Ok? E podes acrescentar vários. Quem diz aqui o LTO4... Ah, bom, deixa eu vou continuar. Ok, let's use bconsole. Okay, so first thing what you do is status dir. In here, with status dir, you are able to see the jobs that are run. Okay, so in here, that's a virtual foo, number of files, number of bytes, and finish date. Okay, the above is the next jobs that are going to run, the scheduled jobs, the incremental and the full. So imagine that I want to see my configuration. For example, my file sets configuration. I do a show, tap tap. Okay, so, and for example, file set, sorry. File set. Okay. And so option include this folder, excludes all these ones. Okay. The command show, you can show, you can disable jobs, you can show pool, for example. How the pool is configured, the default pool. So you have all the, okay, this shows you how the pool is configured. So bconsole is very powerful, and you can do something like this. For example, sorry, okay. Outside bconsole, you can send a status dir or run a job or whatever, and you can do after and parse, okay? So you are able to do this. I will show you to execute a backup, okay? So the command to, there is help, sorry. So you have all these commands. Volumes now is the number of volumes that you have in your, it's like the books that you have, okay? It's not very well parsed, sorry about that, but you see volume one, it's an error because I provoked that, but you have append, it's on the storage file, one, last written, number of bytes, stored. How to run a backup? Run. Now I choose backup client 1. I choose modifier. I'm going to choose the level. Put it to full. Okay. Job queued. Now I do a status dir, and you can see here, it's running, okay? If we do again, it's running. I don't see, without network, I don't know if it's going to work, but yeah, it worked. It was fast. Okay, I have a full 246 files, 19 megabytes. And backup client was this one. So this is how I run a backup job, okay? How I do a restore? Simple. I do restore like this. Then you have all these options for restore. list the last 20 jobs run, list jobs where given file, saved. Enter a list of comma separated job IDs. I can restore a full pack of job IDs. I can do SQL. I can send SQL commands to do a restore. And even works with regex expressions. Select the most recent backup of a client, enter a list of files, find job IDs for before a specified date. In this case, because this is an example, I'm going to choose 3, okay? And I will going to choose 26, okay? 26 because it's the job ID. Now, as you can see, it does a directory 3, and I can navigate inside. Okay, I do mark zik and mark user. Okay, I'm choosing the files that I want to restore. I do done. And then now I can choose where I'm going to restore my files. I can restore for my own machine where the directory is or to another completely different machine. Okay, now I, because where it doesn't exist, I will change this. Okay, so I will do mod and say where, okay, choose option 9. And I want to restore to here. Okay, now I do a yes. Let's do status there. And it was so fast that you already have here. Okay, if I go so you have here user. If you want, it preserves. In this case, I didn't care, but I could remove that. I even can do something on the fly. For example, imagine that you did a backup with a folder name of a customer ID, or mailbox, for example. And now you want to restore with a different name. Or you have lots of files with a different name because the version of the application changes. So you can do a restore and insert in the middle of the restore a regex expression and say that the file with that regex valid field can change the name and it will change all the files names. For example, user 1, user 2, user 3, you can have that. Yes. So this is how is Buckle Community Edition, okay? This is a basic workshop, okay? It's not very advanced, but yeah. So you have lots of things that you can do with... have another issue, for example. Let me show you. Okay. That's simple. There is, in this file, for example, you can put SQL queries inside that you can develop. We already have 30 queries already done that you can use inside BEE to consult the catalog. So you can do something. But in this case, there is the miss the file. For example, you do like this. Yeah. Let me see. OPT Buckle script. Não tem. Sim, mas está zipado. Mas pronto. Mas aquilo é um ficheiro, tem lá umas SQL queries que vocês podem utilizar para consultar o catálogo. Agora, isto tem coisas muito mais... por exemplo... For example, imagine that you have your tape library with 20 drives. One of the drives, it malfunctions. And you cannot stop all the backups. You just do a disable storage file 1 drive equal to 0. Okay? And you disable that drive. You can do this on the fly. And B will not ever again use that drive until you enable it again. So you can contact your support, change your drive, and then do an enable again. So, okay. You can have something like this, for example. See the job logs or a job ID, for example, 26. Okay. So this is the job logs of that job. Start backup client, the file changer used, the volume used, the time, the spool attributes, the client, the file set used, the pool, the catalog, started time, end time, priority, FD bytes written, SD bytes written, the rate, and conline compression. If you have deduplication, it will appear here, a software compression, and you will see the ratio. And encryption, no, and I set accurate to active. List pools. There is one thing. Did you notice we have here a scratch pool? Okay. What's a scratch pool? In Backlog Community Edition, normally in the tape library, you have partitions. You can divide the tape library in partitions. It's a way of managing volumes inside the tape library. Okay. But we advise not to do that. You show all the one partition to a backlog storage daemon or a backlog director, one partition with all the volumes. And then we have a pool called scratch. It means when backlog picks up a tape, uses, then when it recycles, it picks the tape and puts on the pool scratch. And the pool scratch is like a bag full of tapes. So every time that Backlog needs a new pool, a new tape, is going to look to the scratch pool and picks up again. So you don't need to have a management of the pools because Backlog does that management for you. Okay? And you can set, for example, a pool just for scratch, picking up tapes, and another pool just for dumping them after using one time. You can have that. For archive, for example, or because you just want to use one time to put it inside the bag and then go to a safe place, you can have that. So that's the beauty of pools. And you can set pools for tapes and pools for file systems. You can set, for example, incremental jobs, because most of the people, when they want a restore, it's a restore for 2 days ago, or for that hour. Oh, I delete the file. They want for that hour or for 2 days ago. So you can have, for example, backups, incremental backups or differential incremental, or one full just for a file, okay? One full for file storage that is going to be quick to restore, and have the monthly backups to tape. So when you do a restore, you do on the first week. And it'd be easier. So
like you keep a copy of the backups and the live storage device, and then after you
Yeah. You've offloaded to a tape library. Yeah. That's it. You can have that. It permits that. It permits also, do you see this name? I will show you. Okay. Do you see this name? Volume 001. This is customizable. Okay, you can set something like date, name, client name, okay, with a regular expression. You are able to do that. Year, okay. Everything here, this is the volume name where you store the things. Let me show you if you have... Oh, you have a nice command. For example, I want to know how many, before I started to select the files I want to backup, I want to know how long it takes to do a backup. I can do this, estimate, client, and it'll give me the time it will take to do a backup. Backup client. So, two? No, it's not possible. The restore for us is like, you need to restore. Okay, you have functionality, but in terms of estimate, I don't think they give you an estimation. But I can, you just give me a nice feature request. Yeah, I will, okay. One thing about Bakula Enterprise Edition. We have lots of customers asking for feature requests, okay? I'll show you, for example, this one. I said status dir, okay? It shows the status of the director. This line, Damon started that, it was a, this line, conf reloaded at, means that the configuration was changed at 2000. This line was a feature request for a customer. Okay, so it's released on the community version, but this kind of features we are open it. We are open to. So, and it's very common to release this kind of features. So status is now, for example, these numbers of clients, numbers of storage, number of spools, catalogs, file sets, schedules. Let me show you. You have auto mount, you have cloud, okay, specify cloud commands, create a DB pool, you can delete a volume or a pool or a job, you have estimate. What? Yes. You can set a schedule or you can set by hand. And it does one thing. It does a cache locally and then sends the parts when available. Okay? It doesn't send like... Yeah, yeah. Yes, Bakulum.
Yes, please show us your project.
Okay, let me... Now I will go to the... Okay. Let me just... Graphical user interface already, I'm going to show you. Wait. Okay, you have Bakulum. Okay, and this is where you can get it. This was supposed to be the workshop how to install Bakulum. And this is the end, but I will show you, let me Ok. This is Baculum. Okay, you have the same, what I showed you, okay, but a graphical user interface. Jobs, okay, you have details.
Okay, so this one is the one that allows you to create jobs and so on.
Yes, yes. You can configure a job, configure a file set, configure a schedule, run a job, okay, estimate, run job, it starts, okay. It's very well done. Okay, it uses the latest technologies. So I'll go to clients now. So clients, you have this, storages, file volumes, the tapes, schedules. You can add a schedule, level, volume to code. There is some feature I didn't explain you. You can do a volume to catalog. You can do, for example, remember the virus that encrypts the hard drive? Yeah, you can run a job that it doesn't do a backup, but it does a disk to catalog. It's going to check the MD5 string of each file with the MD5 string stored in the catalog. And it will report you the changes to check if was done any change. So you have this kind of, you know, granularity. Okay, this is a single day. I will not create, but you are able to create this. Pools. You have restore wizard, graphs. So you have here graphs. Okay. You can have last 2 weeks or last year. This is another level, okay? So, restore wizard. I want to do a restore. Select this, next. Select, for example, this one. Next. The file. Okay, there was an error here. I don't know why. Wait. Okay. Yeah, a real file. Okay, backlog. Temp restore. Next. Relocate the files, okay? That's why you saw, I didn't care about it, the restore, but you are able not, because if you don't do that, imagine that you are restoring a mailbox of a customer, and you said, okay, I'm going to put on the mailbox, a change mailbox of João. When you do that, you need to go to change mailbox João, exchange mailbox João, and there is the mailbox. Okay, that's why, Yeah. It depends how you, for default, we do that. Okay. We append the string everywhere you put it for not destroying the customer. Okay. Okay. Next, I click next. Run restore. And running jobs one. And refresh log. And you can see. Okay, this is Baculum. Okay, I didn't show you Reportla because Baculum is much more better now. That
I've never used this one, I've never used the other graphs. Yeah. The other graphical interface.
Baculum web.
Yeah.
Mine.
Cumbersome.
Yeah. Mine, I will show you. Let me. It's free. It's free. Everything I showed you here, it's free. Everything is free. I'll show you one thing that mine has. I hope. Oh, okay. 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 This is Reportla. Okay. So you have. Mine is able to do a LDAP authentication with users. It has 6 years now. Okay. So this is technology of 6 years. So we had jQuery and configuration. What mine has, it didn't have, and Backlum doesn't have, is this one. I developed a relationship of evolution of your backups. So you are able to see how is your infrastructure growing in terms of number of files and number of computers or number of bytes. And why this? Because when you arrive to your IT director and ask, hey, look, I need more storage for backups. And he says, oh, because of this graphic. Okay, mine does this. Backlum, I think, doesn't do, but mine. But you can do this with SQL, okay? Yes, yes, no, no, yeah. You can have two, because mine doesn't change the catalog. It only consults, yeah, yeah. And it has in GitHub, so you can go there and see the SQL and everything. So it has a nice calendar. For example, we had statistics of OK jobs and volume spools. I use a VTL. You have this file retention 5 years, and these nice graphics. Yeah, and that's all about Reportla. And you have Backlum, okay. Multi-user, layered, attractive, stable, wizard, and you have Bakula Web. Bakula. Oh, it's under maintenance. Okay. Yeah, and that's all I have. Let me. Yeah. I'll give you a card. Okay. And I think I don't have anything. I don't have anything. Any questions? No? You can ask now.
Well, to be honest, I'm not the expected guy.
But I convinced you. Okay, thank you very much for the opportunity.
Yep.
Okay.